Well, I think some of the people, most of the people who follow work know. They know what's going on. We're preaching to the choir for the most part. And these are the people I say, please, you know, if this is getting through to you, don't keep this stuff quiet. Share it. Get it out there. Start talking about it. And, you know, most of the time you're going to fall on deaf ears. Believe me, my own family, people, they don't see it. It's an insane kind of a situation, but it's also they do it on purpose. People can't cope. So what do? They shut themselves down. They don't want to hear it. Then they get angry at you. How many people have you had over the years that lash out at you?
Oh my God. Yes.
And then you could probably get some of those same people that come back and say, you know what? I apologize. You were right. Now I see it. So I love that more than anything else. When I get someone that was, let's say, anti Greg Mannarino, all of a sudden turn around and say, you know what, Greg, you were right. I see it happening now. And I see more and more of this, I think. I hope we need to see. You see, look, our channels, you and I, we're okay. We're pretty big, but we're not even close.
Oh, no.
We would need to, you know, get through that. We need 10 times the people that we have to follow us. And this is where our followers come in. To share this stuff, get people to subscribe, get people to listen to what's going on. I urge people to start their own channels. You know, I tell people, you know, just do your own research. If you understand this, it's like an epiphany. People get it. It's like a bell goes off and all of a sudden they get it. And so if you're one of these people, get out there, start talking about it. It doesn't have to be just, you know, you and I, it could be anybody else.
Right, exactly. And I know that this is a big problem for a lot of people. What you said, that people that you know and care about, whatever, think that you're insane because you're talking about this. And some will have that epiphany, some won't. But
they can't. They're blocked. They have that, you know, they've been controlled. They've been conditioned. Whatever it might be, they've been programmed literally by the, I'm pointing out there because there's a big screen TV here, but that's the box there that, you know, is flashing all these messages at people. Turn that stuff off, because all you're going to get from that is lie and deception and look here, don't look over there.
Right.
That's what it's designed to do. All those people there, they're reading a freaking script. And they're, you know, like you and me, we're just talking. You know, these people there, they know what they have their teleprompter. Say this. They say the wrong thing. The little thing goes off in the area. Oh, no. Don't do that. Oh, it's crazy.
It is. Do you have any advice for helping people? And I know this is the hardest question, and people ask me this, and I don't have a good answer for it, but maybe you do, which is, you know, how do you talk to people to help sway them to at least start to open their mind? Because then you have, I mean, we're asking people to have a paradigm shift. And that means we're asking people to realize that they have been sold lies their entire lives. So how do you just crack that door open just a teeny bit so that some light can come in? Do you have any advice?
You know, there are some people, and I would like to think that you and I are these kinds of people and people that follow our work that are able to think a little more abstractly than most people. It's the conditioning from childhood, like you were going on, told repeated lie after lie. You show people some truth, they get angry. But there are some people, that understand, they're receptive, they're able to think outside the box. You're going to talk to maybe, I don't know, 10 people, if you're lucky, maybe one is going to be able to think outside the box and see what's going on. People know something. The thing is, to me, and I talk to a lot of people, they know something's wrong. They could feel it in their gut. They have this God-given gift, this intuition, whatever you want to call it. They just know there's a negative feeling or whatever it might be, an intellect, whatever you want to call it. And people, they get it. Some people just, because of fear or because of just they're incapable of thinking outside the box. Not everyone's able to do it. I mean, I think, you know, it's just the way it is, unfortunately. But I think that people realize that something is wrong. If you're in a conversation with someone, you can't start it off with, hey, you know what, this is what's going on, because they might think you're insane. But listen to the person you're talking to, what's coming out of their mouth, what's their body language, then maybe you can find a way to get in here. Well, have you thought about this? And what do you know about central banking? And see where they go. And if you see you have a person that, hey, you know, this person might be receptive to hearing some truth without getting angry and turning it all off. Then you can pursue. But some people are just going to block it no matter what. Mm-hmm. You can tell people that water is wet. They won't believe it. Some people, you can tell them that the sky is blue. They won't believe it, or whatever it might be. They have their fixed mindset. They can't change and they won't change. But some people will.
Yeah. Okay. So I got to ask you, what keeps you up at night these days?
Oh, what biggest bugaboo. Yeah. I don't know, really. You know, I try to maintain a positive mindset. I really, really do. I try not to. What keeps me up at night lately is wondering how I'm gonna be. What I'm gonna do with my race cars. Honestly, I don't think trying. I try to disconnect myself from this. I used.
Oh, you have to sometimes.
Sleep, grinding my teeth to death. Oh. You know, like the stress and not being able to sleep. That was something that has plagued me for many, many years. But I think as I'm getting older and maybe mellowing out a little bit, maybe a lot of my followers would say, no, that's not true. But I try not to do that. I try to disconnect myself from it a little more so than I was in the past, because I wouldn't stop even at night. It's very difficult. You know, what keeps me up at night thinking where we're going. And I hate thinking that people are hurting and people are suffering, and they
exactly.
are. I want people to be happy and not stress out. But it's very difficult. I mean, you know, I was hearing from my sister this morning, who just was diagnosed with cancer, by the way, terribly.
So sorry.
And she's like,
that.
I can't cope. I'm having so much stress and I don't know what to do. You know, I'm like, just kind of relax. You know, just instead of stressing out about it, think about what you need to do to reach your goal. You know, we all have to have a goal to work towards. So try to maintain a positive attitude no matter what's thrown at you, and figure if you're in a bad spot, try to figure your way out of it. Say, okay, this is what I need to do without getting flustered.
Right. Or stressed, because stress can do all sorts of really negative things to your body.
I think that's why my sister got ill, is because of her stress level, because she was having a lot of personal problems. And the stress of all that is what disrupted her immune system from working properly. And then she's got cancer. You know, it's a proven fact that stress can do anything. Stress can kill you.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I think that, you know, thank goodness I saw the writing on the wall, particularly in 2008. For me, that's when I absolutely 100% knew the system died and was just put on life support till they could get the next one in place. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I'm a very happy person, and I'm not a particularly stressed person.
You're always
happy.
That's why I love talking to you. I love it.
Exactly. Thank you. But that's because I'm prepared.
Yeah.
Right? I have all of those things of the mantra in place down here and up at the bug out, so I don't have to be stressed, because I put everything in place to make sure that I could take care of not just myself but my family, meaning also my extended family.
Yeah.
You know, and I think that that's a big part of the message, because today we still have choices. We can still buy gold and silver physical and hold it outside of the system. You can still buy some stuff with cash, right? And pull that out of the system. I am not under the impression that they've yet put a new chip in that cash to regulate the interest rates on there. So that's still cash in the wild, preserves your principal, not your purchasing mm-hmm. power, but at least your principal. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I think that I'm a doer, right? And I like to lead by example. That's what you do too.